Cars and renegade, ragtop, revving up an engine. Hell yeah, why not take
I won you over that night in eighth grade with my incredibly amazing charm and my smoother-than-butter pickup lines. God showed you to me that night, but neither of us knew he had much bigger plans for us. You've seen me grow and mature more throughout our relationship, but what makes me so excited is being able to grow and mature with you in our relationship.
First time I saw you, I fell completely in love with you. Even though it was in eighth grade and I got a little crazy, I knew you were what I wanted. Once we found each other again, I prayed. I asked God, if this is the man for me, please make it known. And he did. I didn't have a doubt in my mind that you were my future husband after that day my prayer was answered.
Oh my.
Wings angel,
beautiful.
Crossed the room, crooked smiling. I just had to go there. Sitting with a group of friends and sipping on a glass of red. And I don't remember what I said, but she wrote her number down. All I ever wanted, but never knew I needed. She's a dotted line in every sign that led me straight to Jesus. Was a voice that made me hit the brakes, slow it down, have some faith. And I had to learn from my mistakes. But I'm on the right road now.
I promise to always love and protect you. I promise to always choose you. Choose you when it's easy. Choose you when it's hard. Choose you when we are arguing, irritating, and needing some time to cool off. Because each day I've spent with you, I have only loved you more.
In front of our friends and family, declaring to everyone who I promise to be as your wife, I humbly come before the Lord to declare my unconditional love for you the way that Christ has loved me.
Now you see two young people stand before you, ready to commit themselves not only to each other but to the Lord in holy matrimony, but in such a way that will join their hearts together as only God can do. It's a mystery, it's a wonder, it's beautiful. And I thank you again for coming. One time I remember that he was going to come and visit her. Selah got all dolled up, as a girl normally does, and she sat and waited for him, and he didn't show up. And what at the time was is that he wasn't going to date anyone until he was ready to make a commitment or to see if that girl was the girl to marry. But see, he came to visit me, and I asked him what his intent was, and that's basically what he told me. And then he asked me permission to start dating my daughter. And of course I said yes, as long as you do it right here in front of me. No, I didn't say that.
I've waited 100 years, but I'd wait 1,000,000 more for you.
And I watched them really mature in the Lord in many ways, especially my daughter, in front of which I spent a lot of time with. Then it came the day that Coleby came to me and asked if he could have my daughter's hand in marriage. And of course I said no. But then I talked to him really seriously. And I told him what I would really desire of him. And it really was a simple thing. Commit himself to the Lord, to really find his love, his first love in God. I said, and then that you would love and take care of my daughter your daughter is, you're protecting her, you watch over her, take care of her. And you desire a man that will do the same. And I believe she found that in Coleby. So I told him yes. All alone. What I've been living for.
Your love is my turn. You show me every day how much you love me. You remind me to rely on Christ always, especially in the hard times. Push me to be stronger and to be true to myself. You are exactly who I needed as a husband. Every kiss is a curse
of line. Every touch is a promise to lead you and challenge you to be the best that you can be. To push you to always be the chivalrous, kind, caring, loving, determined, passionate person I see every day.
For the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Daffer.
I think I want you more than want. I know I need you more than need. I wanna hold you more than hold. When you stood in front of me, I think you know me more than know. And you see me more than see. I could die now more.
I think we all know how great of a guy Coleby is. He's an incredibly caring and loving man. Anytime I had anything going on, good or bad, he was there to listen. He's someone you can lean on, someone that would stay up way later than he should to chat with you. I'm positive that the family that he will build with Selah will be just as loving and caring as he is.
I've known Selah since middle age. Coleby, you have a good life with her. I wish you two the best.
Stood there in awe as your date for the prom. I'm blessed as a man to have seen you in white, but I've never seen anything quite like you tonight. No, no, I've never seen anything quite like you tonight. Oh, no, no, I've never seen.
It's a cliche thing to say that I'm not losing a sister, I'm gaining a brother. And while it may be a true statement, I think it's more accurate to say that today I witnessed two of my best friends share their love for one another in the truest sense.
I love you guys, and I'm glad that I'm here to see the beginning of your journey together.
Well, I've seen you in jeans.